fuel to back it up and dump it.
Get it.
Put your arms out front, lean side to side. They gon' be on you when they see you hit that Dougie ride. Ain't nobody hitting with my bro from on the side. He go by Bubba and he hit that death like thunder. Okay, I ain't from Dallas, but I need town boogie. I show my moves on to everybody trying to do it. I lead the functions and all the ladies trying to
if I eat those, these clothes they free though. Straight from the back of the Supreme store.
Y'all get
the back, this back.
This is a DJ Snakehead exclusive.
I want the black kids to like me for this one, man.
Trash Wing! Woo! I'm in your sin! Trash Wing! No! Goofwing! Trash Wing!
Here come with the fucking extras. Big dog, cup full of eggnog. Don't give a fuck about this shit, but it's in camp vlog, no. Hard ass if I eat those. These clothes, they free though. Straight from the back of the Supreme store. Don't give a fuck about these, they just slob knob in New York shows. Thirsty for the till I'm
not. Welcome to Theoretical Thursday. Today we're talking about momentum and collisions. For our example, we will use a football player getting smashed. The change of momentum is the overall change in velocity from the beginning to the end, and it will result in how much a football player would get hurt. We are trying to prove that this is an inelastic collision, meaning that although momentum is considered kinetic energy,
a rebel I be one day on that track with gunplay. Outcast my whole life, so I decide to spit like Andre. Beef is on my entree, gin and juice, that's Bombay. Driving fast the wrong way, I swear life is like a one way. Issa on the Sunday, fitness on the Monday. My new crit came with feng shui in my closet's like a runway. Come be my fiance, she buffed me in the Hyundai. My roots.
They hit Anthony Barr and Matt Barkley. It looked cool, but now we're gonna break it down in terms of physics. So Anthony Barr, we looked up his 40 time and his weight, and we did the same for Matt Barkley. We're just going to assume that Anthony Barr was running at his full speed, and it looked like he was when he was going inside of Matt Barkley. That's all that we can know. And his 40 time is a 4.44, and he weighs 255 pounds. At the time of collision, Matt Barkley was moving 0 meters per second. He was standing still in the pocket, and he weighs 227 pounds. So in order to solve for the final velocity, or really take anything from this, we need to change it into the metric system and find the velocity that they're running at instead of just their 40 times. So for Anthony Barr, we're going to take his 40 yards in 4.44 seconds, and then we know that 1 meter is the same as 1.0936113 yards. So we're going to do that, and we come up with about 8.24 meters per second. That's going to be his velocity at the time of the collision. And then we need the same for his weight, and it converted into the metric system as well, into kilograms. So we have his 255 pounds, you know, the conversion factor, and we come up with 116 for Anthony Barr and 103 kilograms for.
I gotta close the window before I record, cause New York don't know how to be quiet. Coochie down to the side like I'm Biggie Popper. Keep your girl and my Tommy boxes, but when it out, she a silly.
That's the conversions. You come up with the final statistics of Anthony Barr and Matt Barkley at the point of collision. So for Anthony Barr, he's 116 kilograms, moving at 8.24 meters per second. And Matt Barkley is 103 kilograms, moving at 0 meters per second, since he was not moving when he was tackled. So here we're going to solve for the final velocity, and we know that it's an inelastic collision, so we can use this equation. So we're going to plug in the mass and velocity for Anthony Barr at 116 kilograms, 8.24 meters per second, and then add that to the mass and velocity of Matt Barkley, which is really going to cancel out since he's moving at 0 meters per second. And then this is going to be equal to their combined mass, since they stick together, which is 116 plus 103, times the final velocity, which is what we're solving for. So after we do the math multiplication here, we get 955.84. It's going to be equal to 219 times the final velocity. And after the division, we solve and know that the final velocity is 4.36 meters per second, which is the speed that they're going after they stick together after the tackle.
Yeah. Hey. Yeah. Hey. Yeah.
So we just established that this is a completely inelastic collision, and we have also found out that the final velocity is 4.36 meters per second. So if this truly is an inelastic, completely inelastic equation, momentum is going to be conserved throughout. So what we're going to do is we're going to take Anthony Barr's mass and his final velocity during the time of the collision minus their combined mass and their combined velocity, which at the end of the collision is the same thing as like the final velocity, which is 4.36. We just solve for that. And we're going to come up with 955.84 minus 954.84, which is one, which is pretty much nothing. We can account that one. It should be zero, but we can account the error as like an error in rounding. That's how small and insignificant it is. So momentum is conserved, and it does follow as should as an complete.
So now we're going to test if kinetic energy is conserved in the collision that we saw previously. So in order to do so, we're going to do 1/2 mass times velocity squared all across. First doing Anthony Barr initial and Matt Barkley initial added together, which should equal Anthony Barr final and Matt Barkley final. So we plug in all the numbers for their given mass and velocity and do the math, which comes out to be about 200,000 equal to 100,000. So obviously kinetic energy here is not conserved, as it shouldn't be in a completely inelastic.
We them boys! Holla! We them boys!